week thus far.
I'd like to thank AldoFormalWear.com, Craig. You see that? AldoFormalWear.com, all your grad needs. That was me 14 years ago. Wish I was there.
14.
GED, grad,
I'd
anything you
like
want.
I'd also like to thank our head writer, Matt Nightingale. It was very funny.
And everybody else.
Yeah, and those other guys.
No, everybody else is pretty decent.
We have a huge team, actually, to make the show. And most people don't know that. Most of the time, I'll be out at a drinking establishment, and some guy will be like, hey, get me a show, man. And they don't realize it takes. Like, we have 14 people that work on this show.
It was actually me that said that to you, get me my own show.
Surprisingly, you got half.
Lest we forget.
I only give half of what people request.
But we don't hang out very often, because I really don't want to, but we don't hang out very often. But when we do, we had a pretty good weekend just for a team building, because we read each other's throats the last
12 weeks. To be fair, though, hanging out
with
you means like a lot of incense and black lights and all that crap, so
I know what I like. none of those things. As a team building exercise, we actually went out to...
That's right. We went to Adrenaline Adventures, which is on the Perimeter Highway. Didn't get the whole team out. Just got, mostly ourselves. And we did have other people come, though.
Great
exercise, literally. Although... I think maybe your general lack of exercise
fed into
the way it worked out.
Yeah, I just turned 21 11 years ago, and I'm not... You know what, some people are born to climb walls. Some people are born to throw football 6 yards. I was born neither, so I don't know.
So you're like a true fish out of water then.
Well, it was hard. I was impressed. I thought you guys didn't know how to do anything athletic, but you guys...
No, when it comes to climbing and getting away from things, I'm like a pioneer.
Like, we do our own stunts, and we're wall climbing. I felt like Jackie Chan.
You also fell unlike Jackie
Doesn't
Chan.
Doesn't matter. Let me finish this pun. I felt like Jackie Chan in that movie, Rumble in the Bronx, except mine was called Humbled in the Bronx.
Wow. Yeah.
Worth it. Worth the wait.
JD on camera just gave you the finger for that one.
But
I don't know. Why don't we take a look at our adventure?
It's all camera angles.
And Adrenaline Adventures.
Do it. Roll clip. We are here at Adrenaline Adventures with JP, gonna show us the ropes. Got Dan at my side. Probably gonna bust ahead of me. Let's do it.
Why don't we put some gear on then?
Now, ladies watching at home, I've actually put protective padding here as well to begin, so it's a little bit out.
I'm not great with sports, but this looks like a jock strap.
First time climber over here, sorry. I need you to follow me pretty closely.
Yeah, I'll be with
when we do
you
this.
Guys.
He's gonna need help.
This is for the beginners out there. Like, I know what I'm doing, but this is more for the beginners. Maybe seeing Adrenaline Adventures for the first time, so you're welcome. You unhook the claws, right?
No.
No?
No, you hook it onto the loop.
Yeah, big
oh,
time.
Oh, man. Thomas!
No, I got the hard side. Go on, follow me, Dan.
Did Ben fall?
We got what we needed from me.
He totally fell.
No, you guys, don't wait for me. I'll catch up. Craig, adjust the camera so it makes it look like I made it to the top. Oh, this is the worst. This is the cut. All right, so you got the rope part. We're good. Skilled climbers, they put on two ropes to add difficulty. Pull me up. Hang on. I don't need help.
I don't need help. He doesn't want help.
I'm an indoorsman. I'm a great indoorsman.
Yeah. Oh, man. Man, rope burn must be like currency around here. Jesus Christ.
This is scary. Shh, man. Do you switch hands? Do you switch? Do I switch?
Looking good, looking
left or
good.
Right. Left or right? You think I'm joking? You know, Thomas, maybe I'll just meet up with you up there.
You're a humbled man now.
No, I just went for a run earlier.
Not gonna lie to you, my shins are not liking the looks of this plank.
No, man, can you lower it? This is legit scary.
Craig, edit that part where I said it's scary. Give me the easy vine. I'll be John Lithgow from Cliffhanger.
Whoa.
All right. And we're sitting. Cut. This is kill up.
There you go.
Did I ever tell you guys I was at all star in high school football?
You actually look like you're doing it legit.
Green screen something into this. What do I do? Hold on to this?
Yeah, just hold on and then let go.
No, hold on to this. Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained? Thought this place would be a little bit harder.
Differences.
Oh, it was fun.
Yeah, there were differences.
That's a good time up there.
Yeah, another high five. There we go. Perfect. Well, I feel like a team right now. And it's probably a perfect time to bring out another team member. Actually, our friend Mike Green, who is going to present to us an excellent item on Kijiji in his segment known as Sell My Swag. Yeah. Woo!
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
It's great to be here. You guys know I haven't been around for a while, but just because I'm not here, that doesn't mean the deals aren't on Kijiji. They're still piling up. They're still piling up. So much so that for the season finale, I wanted to do a 5-pack for you. CRTC, they don't even like me doing 5-packs. Too crazy, it's too many deals. But you guys are mature enough, I think you can handle it. You guys ready for some Kijiji deals? Jim, let's give him that first slide. We're talking a garbage bag full of plus-size ladies' clothing for $25. Unbelievable Kijiji deal. Now, before we even get into the garbage bag of deal there, let's talk about $25 for something that if you buy it and pick it up, it's already pre-packaged. It's already in the garbage bag. That's added value. You can't beat that. That's added value, ladies and gentlemen. Not to mention, I mean, this is, you know, everybody knows when you're a kid and you go to the grocery store with your parents, the best part was getting to buy stuff from the bulk bin, right? Getting that big scoop and taking stuff away in the bag. This is all the necessity of buying clothes with all the fun of garbage bags of product, right? That's the best. They can't get any better than that. Tim, keep it moving. I know we're just warming up. Let's get him that next deal. 35 romance novels in a box. I can't stress this enough. Nothing's gonna go better with your garbage bag full of plus-size ladies' clothing than a box full of 35 romance novels to read. You guys seem like a literate crowd, you're liking the book deals, but you're saying, hey Mike, we like something a little bit lighter of a read. Let's get with that next one, Tim. A variety of N64 video game manuals. games not included. Hear me out though, folks. I mean, every time a movie comes out, what's everybody saying? Oh, the book is way better. Same principle. Why do you need the game when you got the book? Dan, I mean, we're talking GoldenEye, we're talking Perfect Dark. These are some of the greats. Could this deal get any better?
I don't know.
That's where you're dead wrong, because this guy's gonna throw in the box for Ocarina of Time. The collector's edition gold box. Unbelievable value. I can't stress that enough. I'm not even gonna sweeten that deal anymore. Can't get any sweeter. Phone's already ringing off the hook. We're gonna have to move on to the next set of sales. This one's special. This is for the holistic crowd out there. We're talking wands, we're talking amethyst. Amethyst wands range from $20. Now, I mean, amethyst is good for your healing, it's good for lowering your stress. That's science. That's proven by scientists, ladies and gentlemen. In this case, the scientist is Frank, the gentleman selling the wands. But I believe his facts are straight. I mean, we all know, since time immemorial, when you think quality wands, you think amethyst, am I right? Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Wands pop culture's familiar with is like wooden with feathers and shit on them. I don't think people think of
that. That doesn't know wands. Coach, no, coach. I give you one pick what to build your wand with. What are you going with?
I'm a pretty big wand guy. I go amethyst every single time.
Coach knows wands. All right. Let's all get bogged down this. I can tell you guys you're an amethyst crowd, maybe not a wand crowd though. Tim, let's hit him with that final deal. Crystal amethyst pipes. Unbelievable value. We got a taker over there. We got one taker already. He's keen for crystal. Crazy for crystal. She's cuckoo for crystal. And how can you not be at this price? We're talking $25 to $80. That's your price range. And this way you know when you're smoking your crystal meth, you're going to be absorbing the healing benefits of amethyst at the same time. Unbelievable value. All right, that's my final sale. Are you guys excited for Kijiji?
Yes, we'll be back with the news.
We're going to drop and Craig with the news and we'll be...
For a taste of royalty, head to 120 King Street. Just look at that wood. Week Thus Far tapes at the King's Head Pub every Monday live at 8 p.m.
Oh, yeah. We're back. Ladies and gentlemen, what would happen if you threw a cat on fire into a petroleum farm? It would explode and it would make the news. It's time for the news. Presidential candidate Mitt Romney's under fire this week after it was revealed that he bullied a high school classmate who was presumed to be gay. Romney responded to allegations saying, "I had no idea he was gay. Had I known, I wouldn't have gone anywhere near him." Winnipeg police are trying to explain themselves after video surfaced showing a police officer bumping a jaywalking pedestrian with his cruiser car door. Winnipeg Police Chief Keith McCaskill just filed the officer's actions saying that, or justified the officer's actions, saying that it's all part of the force's new open door policy. The Winnipeg man has been ordered to stop renovations he's been making to his home for the past 24 years following numerous complaints from neighbors. The man said, "Oh, thank God, I didn't have a f***ing clue what I was doing for 24 years. The Manitoba provincial government has introduced new legislation that would ban people from having or building moats or other booby traps on their property. No one was happier to see the new law than the Girl Guides of Canada, who lost 91 members last year due to moats. Lest we forget. A representative of the local Moats Union 585 was crushed by the new law, saying, "I'm 63 years old. All I know is moats." A fight club in Northwest Territories known as bro scrapping is in the news, as there is a pandemic occurring known as bro scrapping. For whatever reason, we've chosen to title it twice. Bro scrapping is where teenagers are fighting each other for fun and post the clips on the internet. Here to raise awareness about the dangers of bro scrapping, Chachi Josh Versace. Evening, Josh.
Yo, that one was for all the ladies, guys, and gay genies out there. Good to have me on the show.
Yeah, nice. Nice to see you.
Yeah, it's great to be here. You know what? Last time I came here under some weird circumstances because the government tried to pass a law to prevent my strip club, Solid Platinum, from hosting a dwarf tossing event. You know, some little people were hurt, some feelings were hurt. I have little feelings, but they were hurt. So I kind of went on a crusade. Now I'm here with a special message for everyone out there. I just wanted to say that we do not condone amateur fighting, as this next video will illustrate. Please, if we could, the clip.
Hey, yo, this is Josh Versace for the week thus far, and we'd like to present to you a new pioneering division in fight sports. It's bro scrapping. We got the man right here in the skins. This is Tim Gray, a.k.a. Castle Grayskull. Over here, we got Tyler Penner rocking the plaid dad. Yo, T-Pain in the building.
All right, gentlemen, you know the rules, right?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, bring it together, touch hands. All right. Now, remember, at the end of all of this, we're still going to be bros.
Yeah, right.
All right. And let's bro it up! Oh, my God. Tim, you actually hit him.
Great, Tim hit me!
Guys, come in here. Tim.
You okay?
That's what happens when you get serious. We get serious. Are you okay, man?
Give me the shoes. Give me your shoes.
Comes over, hits me.
No, I saw it. It was horrible. No, it is a bro scrap, and he turned it into a non-bro scrap. An enemy scrap. Tim, look what you did. Oh, you're dead.
Proud of yourself?
Yeah, day to day. Thing is, Dan, we do not condone amateur fight sports, but if you give the league a title and call all your bros like pros, then suddenly they're registered. I think that's how government works. So I just get all my friends to fight, and then we get them to come down, and you guys can bet on them. So come to Solid Platinum, what do you say?
Yeah,
come on down. We got girls with greased up thingies. We got fucking licorice. I think we still have licorice. There's usually a third thing. We got everything. So come on down.
Yeah, toss it down for Sachi, everybody.
Last Tuesday, Passport Canada confirmed they may soon be issuing transgender-friendly passports, giving holders the option to identify their gender as M, F, or X. The first countries to introduce this new gender option were Transylvania, Novajkia, and Norway. In a recent interview, U.S. President Barack Obama came out in support of gay marriage. Obama also expressed regret that he was not in a more powerful position to do anything about it, saying, "One day I'll make a difference." Basketball superstar Shaquille O'Neal received a PhD in education from Florida's Barry University last week. According to his professor, Shaq's thesis was titled, "The Rise in Popularity of Black Genies in Cinema from 1995 to 1997. Big part of my youth. All of those genies. Convicted fraudster and disgraced media magnate Conrad Black has been granted special permission to live in Canada for 1 year to get his affairs in order. He arrived in Toronto via private jet, and he has returned to his estate in the posh gated community of Bridal Path. This once again proves that crime does not pay. Hockey commentator Ron McLean has been facing criticism over comments he made last week on Hockey Night in Canada, comparing NHL hockey players to the police and firefighters who responded to the 9/11 terrorist attacks. Here to comment on the matter is Don Cherry!
All right, you pansies! Now, Ron, he's a good guy, okay? I mean, he's no Dale Hunter, but, you know, I like Ron. The one thing he's gonna learn, he's on national TV, you can't be going out and offending people, okay? You know, you gotta show some restraint, all right? Show some restraint. Now, do we got a clip of Ron? Or I hope he's listening, or maybe he's hanging out with his boyfriend or something. Do we got a clip of Ron hanging out with his boyfriend? Okay, all right. Well, you don't want to go, the main point, you don't want to go offending people, you know, like minorities and lesbians and all that, right? Okay, now, moving on. I want to talk about the penny. You know, why are we getting rid of the penny? Good Canadian coin? It's a good Canadian coin, okay? Do you want to show the penny just the beauty of a coin, okay? What are we, a bunch of Europeans? We need our small denominations. You got a lot of change in your pockets. It gives you weight, builds character, okay, kids? Keep your pennies. I'm paying $9.84. I'm not rounding up, okay? Not rounding up. Anyways, Kitchener, Ontario. That's a great place. A lot of good people from Kitchener, okay? Scott Stevens from Kitchener. Daryl Sittler. What a guy Daryl Sittler is. Oh, I just like to lick his armpit, taste his sweat, you know? You know what Daryl Sittler's sweat would taste like?
I have no idea.
The troops, right? The troops. Daryl Sittler's sweat tastes like the troops. You heard it from me, all right? Hey. Don Cherry, everybody.
We asked him about Ron McLean. That was all. Ron McLean, Don Cherry. That was it. South Korean custom officials have intercepted thousands of pills filled with powdered human baby flesh being smuggled from China. Ironically, the lead-free pills are one of the only things exported from China that don't harm children. A Windsor, Ontario woman gave birth to a baby girl in a Tim Hortons washroom last week. Following the birth, the baby was wrapped in wax paper and placed in a bag with the other day-olds. And that's the news this week. Thank you, everybody. Now, with the news, what do you want to hear after? The weather. And who better to give us the weather than our own weatherman, Timothy Gray.
I'm excited.
Now I'm excited.
My barometer is a barometing.
You're a horrible weatherman.
No!
Last time you were here, it was awful. It was terrible.
That's not true. I am not recognized as a weatherman.
Oh, well. What is your deal?
Well, the weather's great. Don't get me wrong. Like, especially today, oh boy, that was sweet.
It rained like 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, but if you're dancing, it's money.
Right? Damn. Yeah, he's right.
No, I'm doing a new thing now. I'm trying to start my own business. I'm selling it out to networks. Basically, I'm trying to do traffic predictions.
From this desk, or you mean like when there's like during rush hour, like a traffic report?
Like later in the week, like this Friday, there's gonna be a stall on Marion just past.
Oh my goodness!
I got a system. I got a pretty sweet system. You wanna hear what my system?
Yes, tell us about your system.
Yeah, you do.
Hey, right in the mouth. Yeah.
I'm touching his mouth.
It. Yeah, with your finger.
They're clean. My system basically is a guy named Gerald, because weather guys, they go into weather towers, and traffic guys, they go under bridges and give homeless people king cans, and then they give me all their information, because they're connected to the streets, they live in them. They know what's happening out there, Dan.
I think I understand, yeah.
They're lucid, some of them.
So what have you got for us this week?
Okay, according to my friend, there's going to be lightning that's going to blow up a bus. And then that bus is going to turn into a dinosaur. And he's going to give out money to people living under bridges.
I don't know if that had anything to do with the traffic at all.
Just what I'm saying
I think that's actually the plot of Godzilla minus a few things.
All I'm saying is stay off the streets of Japan for the next little while.
That's valid. That's
expect a few delays. That's all I got.
All right, well, thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. Tim Gray, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, look at that dance. Big fan of mass transit and Godzilla. Well, before we go to the break, we have one more thing we'd like to share with you. Our friend, Chashi Josh Versace, who was sitting here just a minute ago, has another thing that he would like to educate you on. And that would be big timing, because it's an art, believe me. I've been big time, and I've also big time people small time, because that's just who I am. Now, without further ado, the art of big timing.
Boom! Welcome to a new life. My name is Chachi Just Versace, but you probably already knew that. International man of worth, affluence, porno, and all the other luxurious sumsuches that make life worth living. It's not easy to be me, but it's a lot harder being most of the other douchebags out there. And that's why I come up with this educational series, The Art of the Big Time. Big time. Big time. What is big timing? Good question. Sunglasses on. Big timing is all about bringing down somebody by using as little words possible, like a boss. Donald Trump said, you need to be able to say what you want in business in 10 words or less. Why not say what you want out of life by ignoring people and making them feel insecure? I'm going to provide a couple small examples, then you can work through some exercises yourself. Check it out.
Yo, you use up all my product player? I had half a bottle left. What, your hair's so greasy you got to use it all up? Come on, man. It's not cool. We can't be roommates if you're doing this stuff all the time.
What song is that?
What?
It's from a song, right? What album is that?
No, it's not a song. It's just, I'm saying, if you at least ask, you know, like if you're going to use my stuff.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
It's just, all right, you know, I'm sorry I said your hair looks greasy. It looks pretty good, all right?
Apology accepted.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
There it is. Did you see that? Some imaginary song I made up was way more important than anything in my douchebag roommate's reality. That's the art of the big time. I'm gonna step out and tag in some of my friends with minor examples.
Excuse me, sir. Crosswalk's just up the way there.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know. I'm not really sir,
current. I'm going to have to give you a ticket for jaywalking.
A ticket for jaywalking?
Sir, please lower your voice, sir.
I have rights.
Sir?
Okay, don't tase me, bro.
Oh, yeah, I can do that.
Wait. No.
Freeze. First of all, never challenge a police officer's authority. Instead, counter with an absence of a reaction. And counter with the old switcheroo. Check it out.
Excuse me, sir. Crosswalk's just up the way there.
What?
Sir, I'm gonna have to issue you a ticket for jaywalking.
That cop over there, he told me I could do it.
What cop? There's no other cop over there. Sir, I'm gonna have to...
That was excellent. But remember, when you did your big time, that's all you need, you get out of there. If you go too far, your wax wings might melt, like Icarus constructed by his father, Daedalus. Let's take a look at how you can mess it up if you go too far.
What cop? There's no other cop over there. It just... Hey.
There you go. He went too far. Remember, if you're gonna tase a police officer, you can't be holding on to him, because that's how electricity works. Less is more, and nothing is everything when dealing with a bunch of worthless nothings.
So, Mr. Nightingale.
Yeah.
Do you have any salary expectations?
I mean, whatever you think is fair.
Freeze! You want to know what he thinks is fair, bro? You taking the bus to work so he has room to double park his church white f***ing Benzino. Let's do it again. And don't be kind. Big time.
So, Mr. Nightingale. Do you have any salary expectations? Do you have a number in mind?
Oh, of course I have a number in mind. I doubt you do.
Oh, I do. How does 50,000 sound? Have you gotten any other offers? How about 60,000 and you get free sandwiches on Friday? 70,000. 75,000, maybe? What do you want? 100,000. Is that a no?
You got a deal.
Oh, thank God. I'm gonna look so much cooler.
Now that is a great big time. And how did it feel?
It's good. I didn't get the ticket.
And what are you gonna do next?
Oh, I was gonna jaywalk somewhere, you know, get the, What, are you big timing me? You big timing me? You just taught me how to big time, now you're gonna big time me? Listen, I don't need you to big time me, okay? Actually, I'm sorry, Josh, okay? I didn't mean that, all right? I'm sorry.
Apology accepted. Now get out of here. It works every time. Prey upon the insecure and find your way to the top of the ladder. Order now! Or tomorrow.
We'll be right back with Bob Irving. Knuckle.
Boone Burger Cafe. Enjoy on your own or with friends. Canada's first all-vegan burger cafe. 79 Sherbrooke Street.
Yeah! Yeah! Welcome back, everybody. Our next guest is a very special treat for the old ball coach, because I know about the old ball coach. The only thing he loves more than seahorses are sports. So why don't we bring in the voice of the Blue Bombers, CJOB sports director, I believe, I'm pretty sure, he's the man behind all of it, Bob Irving. Ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah. Yeah. Doing research.
How are you, gentlemen? How are you?
Good.
Right here. Right. Yeah, doing research again.
Have a seat. Welcome to the show. How are
you? Nice to be here. Were you guys ziplining earlier? Is that what you were doing?
Yeah, we
were.
Earlier in the day. That's
you need a little work on that, you know?
Oh, I like to pretend.
A little work.
I like to pretend all the sweat is from being active, but no, generally not. Generally from poor diet and
we knew otherwise.
Hot lights. How are things?
Things are good. Yeah, it's great to be here. I'm looking forward to another football season. The Blue Bombers will be starting soon.
And that's right. I heard maybe not in the new stadium right away.
For sure not in the new stadium.
Give us a scoop. Give us a scoop. 2013, 2014, give us a scoop.
I don't think 2013, but it's going to be halfway through 2012.
He's enjoying it. He's a Riders fan. Born in Saskatchewan.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, we all have to be from somewhere, right? I'm from, by the way, I'm from Regina, too.
Yeah. There we go.
And I go back occasionally to remind myself how lucky I am to be in Winnipeg.
Now, Bob.
Yes.
You've been, let's get serious for a second here.
Are you kidding?
No, I never kid. You've been voice to the Bombers since 1973, which coincidentally was the last time on the Grey Cup. Now.
Close.
Name, what is the best, who is your favorite Blue Bomber of all time?
I've been asked that an awful lot.
Okay, forget it. Who is your least favorite Blue Bomber?
Okay. I've been asked that occasionally, too.
All right, who is your, like, Blue Bomber of all time?
I got a lot of those.
Could go either way.
I have a lot of favorite Blue Bombers. Dieter Brock is probably my favorite Bomber quarterback.
Yeah.
Those who go back, yeah, you know, he could throw the proverbial ball through a car wash without it getting wet. You've heard that line before. He had a great arm. Joe Poposky's a friend of mine. Joe Pop.
Joe Pop, Ranger Insurance.
Yeah, Joe Pop. There you go. Good plug for Joe.
With Joe Pop. I know Joe Pop.
Chris Walby, one of the great characters in the history of the Canadian football.
Oh, his hands. You see him on TV. His hands.
They're mangled, yeah. He's an offensive lineman. They spend their whole career.
Now, you have a nickname, too.
Yes.
Speaking of hands.
I do.
Speaking of hands. Yeah, Knuckles.
Well, okay.
Where did Knuckles come from? Yeah. Is that, like, honestly, if that was my nickname, I would tell everyone on the street. I'd just walk up to people and tell them my name is Knuckles.
Like my nickname's Horseface. You know where that comes from. Why are you nicknamed Knuckles?
Richard Harris, who passed away last year, liked to tell people that my nickname was Knuckles because I was a great fighter. Sorry, that's not the truth. I wish it was.
Maybe a baker? Maybe a good kneader?
No.
Maybe that's what?
You're really good with
I'm not bad at that, though. The legendary and late Cactus Jack Wells was famous for giving people nicknames, and he discovered early in our travels on the football beat that I didn't like to fly. And back in those days, they called people who didn't like to fly white knucklers. And therefore, Jack decided I should be called Knuckles, and that was it. Can I tell you a quick story about that?
Yep,
I would love it.
I used to deal with my flying problem, and still do, with alcohol. They say alcohol doesn't solve problems, and I say, well, neither does milk. Anyway.
That's beautiful.
So I'm sitting on a plane one day on the tarmac in Edmonton. This is a number of years ago. And there was a woman sitting beside me with a baby. And I was fidgeting, as I often always do before we're about to take off. And she looked at me, and she said, what's the problem? And I said, well, I'm a bit of a nervous flyer, and I'm getting somewhat afraid because we're about to take off. She said, well, maybe you'd like some of my apple juice. And she had a baby bottle with apple juice. And I said, no, it's okay. She said, I really think you should try it. This is a true story. Try some of my apple juice. I said, no, it's okay. And she looked at me and she said, you should try this. So I'm not too quick on the uptake, but I finally figured
out what's
so I took the top off, and it was straight scotch. True story.
Wow, she'd be good at movie theaters, too.
That's called breastfeeding in Edmonton.
That explains it.
Now, what are the Bombers' odds this year? How are they looking?
Well, they lost some key players in the offseason, but they've also signed some good young talent, so I think they're going to be pretty good. The East is going to be really tough this year. Toronto's acquired Ricky Ray to play quarterback. Hamilton's improved. They have Henry Burris. So I think the East is going to be as competitive as we've seen it, probably in a decade. But I think the Bombers are going to be right in there. It's going to be an exciting year. I'm really
prediction for all our 10 fans at home. Prediction.
10-8. They're going to be 10-8.
They're going to.
What's wrong with that? They're going to make
pretty
this
good.
What's wrong?
10-8. The CFL's pretty good. You're going to make the playoffs, and if they're healthy come playoff time, I think they'll go to the Grey Cup again. There you go.
Yeah. I'd like to have a friendly wager.
Yeah. Let's they'll finish ahead of Saskatchewan.
No. Bottle of apple juice.
Yeah.
Bangeable apple juice.
Okay, yeah, we're on.
You saw that.
We're on.
Now, I'd like to know, do you like shawarma?
Shawarma. Abi Khan's restaurant.
That's right, shawarma time.
I don't know if I like it or not, because I've never had it, but I'm surely going to try.
You've never had shawarma before?
No, I haven't.
Oh, it's delicious.
Well, I lead a sheltered life. What can I say?
It's like a stretched out football that rotates on a thing.
Oh, yeah.
And then you just shave a piece off there.
Okay.
And you put it in a thing. You eat the thing. All right, another time.
All right. Well, I'm willing to give it a try.
You know, Bob, funny, that's actually his football knowledge, what he said.
Until today, I thought footballs were made of shawarma. So. It's like, how do you catch it?
Touch all the cats get around it. Slip out
of your hand. If the Bombers happen not to do well, I do have a backup job in the summer. I'm going to drive Dustin Bufflin's boat.
Yeah, he'll need some help with that, that's for sure. Yeah.
Sorry, Dustin.
That's okay. I'm sure he's fine with it. I'm sure he probably doesn't even know we exist. I'm a big guy. Big time, that guy. Well, thanks for coming out.
Thanks, Bob.
Yeah.
It was great having you.
Thank you.
Now I know the mystery.
Point to the Bombers.
I'm also a terrible flyer. We'll be right back with Matt Nightingale.
Odina Celebration Circle, one great part of one great city. Odina is the Cree word for gate to the stars. It was constructed by Duff Roblin as a formal apology. For what, you ask? Only the stars can answer that question. These days, Odina's circle is primarily used by local youths to connect with the vastness of the universe via canrips. Winnipeg's Stargate. One great part of one great universe.
Oh, I've got terrible teeth. We both suffer the similar... There it is.
Continue.
All right. Our next guest this evening is a fantastic stand-up comedian, very funny guy. He's been a finalist in Winnipeg's Funniest Person with a Day Job, and he was also featured in this year's Winnipeg Comedy Festival.
Yeah.
That's some CBC action for you people at home. Please give a big round of applause for our head writer, Matt Nightingale. Woo!
Right. Thank you. Wow. Where were you guys when they were choosing my jury? Jeez. I'm really pumped. I'm pumped about Winnipeg. I'm pumped about the upcoming Blue Bomber season. They changed their jerseys. They've got a new logo and a new jersey. It's a retro jersey. Looks like the early 1990s, late 80s. I was hoping when I heard that it was going to be a retro jersey, I was hoping it was going to look like the early 1900s, like when they had the leather flaps on their heads for helmets. Do you remember that? What the hell were they thinking back then? Good hustle, kid. Good hustle. You made the team. Go on down to Fabricland and get yourself a helmet. Just ask for Muriel. She'll size you up. Actually, here's $100, kid. Bring back a roll of helmet for the team. I'm happy to be here, by which I mean I'm happy to be alive. I was sick. I was very sick for a little while last summer, for quite a while. Nobody knew what was going on. Doctors, they didn't know what was happening. And I was talking to my dad. My dad said, oh, maybe you're allergic to something. More people now are allergic to things than ever before, which I don't think it's true. I think that we've always been allergic to the things that we've been allergic to. It's just now science has progressed to the point that we know what we're looking at. We can diagnose it. So now it'd be like, hey, did you hear about Kevin? He's allergic to peanuts. But back in the 50s, it would have been like, hey, did you hear about Kevin? He's dead. Just at lunch. I don't know if you know this. You could get dildos at Superstore now. This is a thing. I don't know what series of events led to that happening. I guess they got a lot of complaints from soccer moms who were like, I can't be making all kinds of stops all over the city. I had to verify this last time I was at Superstore. I couldn't wrap my head around this. I was like, oh yeah, I guess it's probably in the bulk section in like a barrel with a scoop and you weigh it. It's a good amount of dildos. Actually, I better call home. I don't even know if we need dildos. Well, I figured we'd get extra because Christmas is at our house this year. Then you slap the twist tie on it, mark down the code for trail mix, and get them real cheap. Cashier guy's like, hey, I thought trail mix was only half dildos. And the other half is raisins. I think we're getting fleeced, Morty. It's not what it is. You guys know that's not what it is. Week Thus Far fans, you guys are a smart crowd, right? You guys are like, of course that's not what it is. It's Superstore. It's a President's Choice dildo. Yellow cylinder. Plain black letters, dildo. A red maple leaf. It's not what it is either. What it is they don't call it a dildo, they call it a self-massager to fool anyone who sees you carrying it. But the problem is not what it's called. The problem is that it looks like a neon boner. You're not fooling anybody by changing the name. That's like if you're a guy and you're into wearing ladies' underwear and you bring a pair of pink panties up to the front and just hanging off of it is a tag that says Star Wars Trilogy. Cashier guy's not gonna be like, oh, I love this trilogy. This is great. Enjoy, enjoy. Not fooling anyone with that one. The only people you're fooling with that are people who are buying it thinking that they're actually getting a massager, right? Like naive 52-year-old high school guidance counselors who are like, oh, these kids will be the death of me. That's who you're fooling, really. Which is why they decided to call it the self-massager, because they know these people exist. They just want to make sure that those people keep it to themselves. They don't need them going up to their colleagues, whoa, these grade nines really got you tense. Look at your jaw muscles. You have to get on the inside, actually. All right, you guys are awesome. Have a great night.
Next guest this evening has been dominating radio waves for an undetermined length of time. Very funny gentleman. He's also got a great musical. I don't know. You know what? We got to bring him up here because we got to talk about it. It's like a collaboration.
You literally don't know.
I don't know what to call it. I know what it is, but I don't know what to call it. Here he is, Brian Cook. He's very eloquent, as you can see. Brian, how are you doing?
I'm good. I don't really know what I'm doing here, but thanks for...
That's fine.
I was told this was an Amway meeting, and I don't... I just needed some really cheap soap, so...
Half the people show up here, they're like, I'm an alcoholic. I'm like, I don't know what to say to you. I have no idea.
Really, in ear, you hear that?
Wow. You can hear it echoing from the walls right now. Now, the thing that I was really horribly describing is a collaboration you recently did. You got into the hip-hop.
Yeah, I didn't. I just got asked. I was in between kind of working on a project with my band Y and doing the radio thing, and I got a call from Fresh IE, and he said, look, I want you to come and do some vocals. He doesn't like sampling, so he said, I want people to come in and write parts. So I came in and wrote some stuff. I did about four songs with him. And then a young guy named St. Chris, who's an amazing hip-hop artist, came in. He just did a song a while back with Rosie Blythe of Enjoy Your Pumas, amazing song. Anyway, so he came in and he said, listen, would you write, I'm putting my coat on. And he goes, listen, man, stay, write a hook. Write another hook for this guy. And I went, okay. I'm thinking, this guy's going to be thinking, who the hell is this?
Yeah.
So I wrote this hook, and that's the song that kind of took off. And then 2 weeks later, I was doing a video, and then I was playing at MTS Center with them. And I'm thinking, I'd like to do this with my band. It'd be kind of cool. But I sat back there and did one song, and I ate a lot of really expensive food. And I drank all the coffee. And
All
of it. No, it was
like,
all.
Who drank all the coffee? Oh, this new guy. We just invited.
I don't know. And they had Subway back there. Can you say Subway?
Subway.
Can I say?
Wow.
Your green room's great. Except I don't understand why there's a urinal in there. But
yeah, our green room is full of urinal cakes and stacked tables.
It's great. It was great.
But let me tell you, you can't eat those cakes.
Yeah, you could have told me that earlier.
You feeling okay now, bro?
No,
can we get him some water?
Yeah, if you just have like a lozenge and one of those little, the flossy things.
Toothbrush.
Would be great.
Yeah.
Is it a toothbrush? I'm sorry, I'm from Saskatchewan originally, so.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Oh, man.
We all run away. It's like an exodus. Please let us go, and we just leave. You know?
This is like a Saskatchewanese anonymous night.
It is, and I don't know how Regina became the capital of Saskatchewan, because I think I never ever used my park rate.
Funny story, in 1903, actually.
Wow.
Yeah, finish it. Finish it, I dare you.
Go ahead.
Well, it was actually called Pile of Bones, where they settled. And then it became Regina, it became the capital. Blah, blah, blah. Enough history. Go on, Brian.
I'm actually from Regina. I don't really care.
Oh, snap. Where are you from, Mr.
I'm
Cook?
Originally from Saskatoon.
Oh, my
sorry.
Like
sorry.
It's any better.
I was there for a very short period of time.
So now you're in Hollywood. How do you like it here?
It's awesome. Yeah. I came to Winnipeg thinking that I would do, acting or music
capital.
Or something, and I ended up in radio. It was the last place I thought I'd go. So, yeah, I wasn't planning on doing radio.
What was your original
music or acting?
Background.
My background was I did some acting. I actually volunteered at a Shaw cable outlet in Saskatoon.
Not bad. Product
placement.
Crazy time in life. Probably just women, drugs.
Yeah, that's where you meet the hottest women at a cable access channel.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Don't we know it?
A lot of stretchy jeans and acne medication.
But they're women. Right?
It was like being at Comic-Con. It was great. I think she went there at Comic-Con. So.
Cable access TV is somehow below the Comic-Con.
I don't know. I just, it was good times. I remember.
Shoutouts to Comic-Con. They were a sponsor once upon a time.
So I got on the radio, and then it was weird. I came to Winnipeg, and I was working actually at a window factory loading trucks, because that's how successful. I came really from school, moved to Winnipeg. I just didn't know what to do. Worked there, and I thought, I'm going to make a demo tape on a boombox and just send it to everybody and see what happens as a joke. And I got a couple calls back saying, you really should work at this, work your way up. I had a couple guys tell me I was crap. I went, oh, okay. Then I got a phone call from City FM, a guy named Don Kay says, come on in. I said, I think you rejected me already. No, that was the other guy. So I come in, and he's the CEO, and he tells me that, I think if we could train you and just kind of stick you on the air, you might be good. And I went, okay.
And that's probably one of the better ones, I
and
imagine.
And I don't have any broadcast experience. So I kept getting asked to come speak at broadcast schools, and I go, well, just so you know, I haven't actually been to broadcast school, so I could tell you things like, ignore your program director. When he tells you to tighten your bits, don't. And, just show up as late as possible and drink a lot of coffee and don't plan anything. But from there, and I kind of started pursuing the music thing after I'd been on radio for a little while and was paying the bills. But I remember that first year on the air, I had no idea what I was doing. I think I was pulling in 14 grand a year. And I remember
this high roller over
it was here. It was crazy. Value Village got to know me very well. And
how's Don doing over there?
It's great. I don't buy the underwear anymore. I realized my bed bug collection is big enough now. Are they a sponsor? They're not a sponsor, are they?
Who lives in the big
box? So there's bed bugs at Value Village, and there isn't. I'm sure there isn't.
Maybe. We don't know. We have no idea.
I can't explain the bites. So anyway, I did that for a bit, and of course, I realized the sales guys were going, this isn't going to work. What are you doing? I said, well, I'm just going to do kind of like what you guys are doing, only on radio. And most at that time, everyone on the air was sort of, okay, that was Guns N' Roses coming up next. We're going to blah, 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 blah. And I always talk to these guys, and they go, hey, you got, okay, pipes. I went,
What are you talking about?
Smoky pipes.
You don't shout enough.
Yeah, and it was always, so where'd you start? And my first day on the air, I met a guy, I'm not going to mention his name, and he went, so where'd you start? I went, I was at Walmart Windows, and we could go loading trucks, and they wouldn't let me use this nail gun, so I got to use the staple gun, and I stapled my hand to a window, so I ended up here. So yeah, so staple your hand to a window, radio.
So you had some window pain.
Oh my God.
So you could be in radio.
Brian, your band, why, do you have an upcoming show?
Actually, we're right now, actually rehearsing Thursday night. We're just right now retooling some songs, and I kind of got sidetracked with the Fresh Eye thing. He keeps bringing me into shows, and so I'll kind of do that because there's lots of really good food as opposed to playing the diets I'm used to playing.
Got food, you should call me. I never eat.
I'll bring you. I'll say you're like my agent or something. But no,
can I be your son?
Please, I would appreciate it if you could be my son, and then you could mow my lawn because I hate doing it.
But Daddy, I hate mowing the lawn.
It's a push mower, and it'll make you a proper man.
Ah!
Anyway, now get the weed bar and get your ass outside.
Brian Cook, thanks for coming down.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
For a taste of royalty, head to 120 King Street. Just look at that wood. Week Thus Far tapes at the King's Head Pub every Monday live at 8 p.m.
That was fun.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a gas. It's been a blast. It's been a mass of fun times, let me tell you. We're at the end of the show,
end of the season.
Season 3 is finally done. We got some sponsors we need to thank. Number one, Aldo Formalwear.
AldoFormalwear.com. All your grad needs. Notre Dame and Princeton. Go see Ken. He'll hook you up.
Yeah.
He'll hook you up.
Interesting fact, I actually got my grad suit from Aldo.
5 years ago?
Yeah. You can take that to the bank.
Good as money.
Yeah, that's what that is. Also want to thank Adrenaline Adventures for
obvious
reasons.
Really good fun.
Also to thank Fantasy Boutique. They've been giving us these awesome little sex baskets that we've been giving away to guests and people that come to the show. Yeah. Also cash, straight sex cash is what it is.
Not like that.
In case
that,
you don't know what I'm talking about, it is a store that sells
books,
you know, sex accessories, if you will. You know, like
and window pane was bad.
You know, and you can put one on your face, I imagine. Also, want to thank the King's Head Pub for having us all season long.
Stellar.
And finally, Endo Clothing.
Endo Clothing for t-shirts.
I want to thank Nolan.
Nolan and Endo Clothing.
Nifty guy. Ball coach, you got anything you would like to add to the end of the show?
Thank the fans who come out each and every week to help support us here, week thus far. Thank the whole crew, all of us. We're on the show because we're the best looking, but we're all equals. We all work as hard.
That is true. Out of 14 people, easily
we were
the best
looking, unfortunately.
Yeah.
So
we didn't even
not a handsome crew.
We didn't need to bring a judge in. We just knew. I don't know. Why don't we hit him with a joke? You got a joke that you want to tell?
I'm out. I had a window pane and that was it.
Why are spicy peppers the rudest peppers of all? Because they're always hollop in your face. Ugh. Our musical guests tonight are a very excellent group. They close us out season 1. They'll be playing at Mondragon on May 26th at 6 p.m., as well as VP Nights June 2nd and a placenta of other nights. I know what it did. Here they are, Mogley and the Forest Creatures. Woo!
When you will return her to me, put my hands together, wondering when you will return her here. Oh, she better come back. Don't agree with him, 'cause I don't wish to die alone. Oh, you better come back. Oh, you better come back. Oh, you better. Behave myself, you just return her.